officially been in Avail 7 years.
And how?
Unofficially, I've been in for almost 10.
And how many years does Avail exist?
Was it 97? Like 10, almost?
I said from the beginning.
Kinda, but never as like a... I'm Bo from Avail. Just some of that was with the band.
You just, you know, hitchhike with them, basically.
Pretty much, yeah. For a while, I was homeless, so I was the roadie. I got $5 a show.
Oh.
So they didn't get paid, but I got paid $5 a show to go. But I have to take care of all the, like, when we go on tour, I take care of all the other stuff.
The financial stuff?
Yeah, like, I'm the guy that comes in and deals with the clubs and the promoters and the people that set the shows up and make sure we have a place to stay and...
Organize.
I do everything, and everybody kind of goes, yeah, you know, so that's my job. So besides doing the jump around shit, I have to make sure everybody eats. And, you know, we have vegans, make sure they have food. Just dumb shit.
I heard that you were in the Navy.
Yes, I was.
Yeah.
Yes, I was. I was in the Navy for officially 2 years, but I was only in for a year because I deserted for a year.
What made you go to the Navy? I mean, what?
Yeah. Pro-American skinhead.
Oh, so?
So I joined the... Serve my country.
When was that?
I was 17.
When were you 17? I mean, like, how many years ago?
Jeez. It's 9 years ago.
Ah, so like you were in a villain, then you broke off into the Navy?
Yeah. And then... Hated it. Split. Deserted for a year. So, then did stuff with Avail for then, and then went back and got out. And came back to Avail. But I do think everybody should do a year.
Of our military service?
Yeah.
Why?
That's not very Avail, not very punk rock, but... Because it teaches you certain skills, like, any type of military teaches you certain skills. Taught me a lot that I use, actually, for Avail, meaning I know how to pack really well. It's just goofy shit like that. Gives you a little bit more
attention to detail.
Yeah, attention to detail. Right.
Sorry, we just allowed our fucking bass cut breaks really slow. Now we got echo.
You protect you, no, it's
few certain issues about Richmond, Virginia, mm-hmm. that we all stay behind. But we're so, I think that's one of the main reasons that we've been successful in that political arena is because we all have such different attitudes about so many things. Like, nobody will agree with me about military service. So, you know, and Tim can be so anti one thing that it's insane, and I can be so pro the same thing that it's insane.
Okay, so you guys know, guys and girls know that if you guys had all been here for all the other shows, like as many people as there are now, you wouldn't have to worry about this with ABC. Something to think about.
Yeah! I'm not touching it.
That tastes good too.
So wait, that one?
Just the way. Hey, Adrian, can you hold this for a second? Adrian, can you hold this for a second?
Play some more songs about girls.
Bobby!
Songs about the girl that broke my heart. All the songs tonight are all about all the girls that we never loved before.
Yeah, you like that. You like that. All these songs are about women.
Daddy,
my red shirt. This next song is about a girl.
Yeah, yeah.
Ooh, it feels good in here.
Feels like a Turkish bath.
Yeah.
set you claim, man.
Sure.
425.
You know my shoes.
How many do you have now?
44 pairs of shoes.
44 pairs of 44. Shoes.
And he knows that he has 44 pairs.
This like is American punk rock, right here.
American
punk rock. It's all about shoes. Don't let anybody tell you any differently.
Stop calling. I want to talk to you.
This is one pair of bar.
I like those ones better.
I like them both. These ones look better from the top, though.
With the bluer ones?
These ones look better from the top.
They look bad from the side.
Yeah.
No, they look alright from the side.
No, they look very dumb.
Yeah. Whatever.
You have this weird number thing going on. I mean, is that why you're so good in counting money?
Oh, so now we're going to go on the number thing, huh?
Oh, yeah. I'm going to nail you for every rumor there is.
Anal retentive. And I have obsessive compulsive disorder, which means that I count everything, and everything needs to be folded a certain way, and everything is that way. Everything has to have its own certain little place, and yeah, that's a major reason I do money.
Mm.
Because I'll count the money 10 times, and I want to know all the numbers for everything. And that way, in the bow language, so I know where everything is, but then in the punk rock language, I can say, okay, you know, I can go up to, you know, first band to the last band and say, this is what we made, this is what we did, this is what you're getting, this is what they're getting,
mm-hmm.
and nobody feels fucked. So it's like, yeah, that's one of the main reasons that I got it. Because it's like a weird, stressful job, and it stresses me out sometimes, but the fact that I'm insane helps, because I'd be doing it anyway.
Yeah.
So I might as well be doing it. And
be responsible.
Being responsible and actually doing it for the band as opposed to the band.
I mean, like, isn't, like, things would be... How did you get inside the punk rock scene? I mean, like, what pushed you in? I mean, what was the interest in it for you?
When I was little, just I mean, it sounds really cliche, but it didn't really fit in very well, because I was a, you know, small, skinny, spastic kid.
You always have that beard?
Yeah, ever since I was 2.
Yeah.
I've always had the
freak.
Yeah, always had it. So, you know, it just seemed like the logical progression. Mm. Skate kid and listen to fast music, and it's just something that happened.
Mm.
I'm still a hardcore kid, even though I'm 26, I'm still a punk kid. So.
What's written on your hand?
Bow. It's better than skinhead, so.
Thank you.
punks about not being held down to, you know, society, yada. I mean, it all sounds really cliche, but everything that you'd read in a 14-year-old punk rock fanzine is not being held down, doing what you want to do, fuck everybody, hang out with your friends, and be dumb. I mean, that's what punk rock is to me, and politics has absolutely nothing to do with that.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, if there's a political system that has to do with that, I'll be into it, but there is no such political system.
You like that? You like that shit, huh?
Much fun.
Somebody dancing around and getting crazy.
Yeah, I mean that's what a show's all about, you know. That's what I mean. A lot of bands will go through the movements of, this is our speech, this is our music, this is our deal, this is our politics.
Mm.
We don't really have that, you know. We don't really have the speech. We don't really have the politics as a band, you know. Then other bands will come in and be like, this, we're musicians and this is what we want to do, and here you go, you know. And I was brought up listening to, like, Circle Jerks, you know, where guys would have, like, a beer and a cigarette and just be like, yeah, so what, we're from Southern California, fuck you, we're dumb, you know. And that's the kind of stuff I was brought up in. listen to. So that's like, that's where I get it, you know. It's like, yeah, okay, so I'm fucking skinny and I weigh 140 pounds and I'm crazy and whatever, and I'll take my clothes off and roll around on the ground and I don't care. That's, I mean, it's fun. If I can do it, then you can do it. And who gives a shit?
Get hassled? I mean, for...
All the time. All the time. People are like, why are you there? What do you do musically? Why are you there? In Europe, they fucking can't stand me half the time. They're just like, what is your job? Why are you there? Because you don't play an instrument. You're not a singer. Why? What do you do that's so good? Why? Oh, yeah. I hope you don't get paid because you're worthless. And it's like, well, that's cool. And then they'll like do like the, so you are the same as the Mighty Mighty Bosstones. And I'm like, no, I'm not, you know. Yeah, okay, I'm a dancer, he's a dancer, but I'm part of the band. That guy's just a schmuck, you know. Yeah. And he does it to get the crowd riled and yada-da-yada-da, and I just do it because I'm small, and if I was to do all this stuff, you know, dancing like last night, I would have gotten my butt kicked in because I'm too small to dance like those guys dance.
Yeah.
So it just makes more sense for me to dance on the stage and have a good time doing it.
And get all the attention.
Yeah,
do the
right.
Weird movement.
Right. Yeah, come on now. You know, I mean, it's the truth. Be it punk rock or be it fucking rock and roll, the singer gets the attention, man.
Yeah.
Singer, then the guitarist. I mean, that's
yeah.
Just the way it works. The only reason I get half the attention that I do is because I'll jump right up in your face and give you a hard time about anything. And I don't care if I'd known you 10 minutes or 10 days. It's just about having a good time. I don't give a shit.
Mm.
It's cool. That's what makes it kind of fun, because it's like, ha, I'm going to be up here no matter how much you hate me. And you know?
Thank you.
Hi, we're Led Zeppelin. And you can tell we're Led Zeppelin by the bulge in my pants. Did you guys like it when Guapper did the Pledge of Allegiance for no reason earlier? Did anybody see that? No.
Because all you jerks were outside when the other bands were playing, weren't you? Yeah, you fucking jackoffs.
Stop.
So how y'all doing since the last time we were up here? Just a couple months ago, right? We went home, took showers, and changed our clothes and came right back. The fellow has to be in biology class by 6 a.m. tomorrow.
7:45.
He's an intellectual, you know.
Oh, yeah.
The Duke.
I have every single one of his movies on video cassette. Think I'm fucking around?
American Hero, John Wayne.
So when you're not touring, what do?
I work. I pierce.
What?
I pierce.
Oh, you pierce?
He pierces his belly button. I'm a body piercer. That's what I do. And I work at a tattoo shop and I hang out. That's what I do.
And the tattoos that you have on your body, you do some yourself or get some?
I sign a cross and then the skull. Hmm. And I tattooed Lars and Brett from Rancid. I tattooed Eric. Tattooed like 40 people.
Wow, you tattooed people from Avail, wow.
And Rancid.
And Rancid.
That's right.
Wow, you're famous.
That's right, that's me. Famous Bo.
Yeah, that weird guy who always has to shove himself inside the shows of Avail.
Yeah.
He won't tattoo me though. What? I asked him to tattoo me and he wouldn't do it.
They're numbers. I have to go by numbers. And 13, I'm on number 13 and that's Jeff's. So I have to do Jeff, and then I can go from there. So.
This is going to be our last song.
Tuesday!
We didn't play more. We're honored to be able to do this show at ABC No Rio. Let's all keep our fingers crossed that this place continues to do great things.
And that's my final comment for tonight, except don't throw up in the sink. Yay, Neil. Yeah, we appreciate everybody who is involved in getting this going. And thanks, Neil, for helping us all week. Neil hates it when we wait. Thanks, Chris, for helping us all week. Thanks to the Israelis for helping us all week. And Kristen and Greg and, you know, all those honkies.
And it's called the Trooper.
Yeah, every time we play in New York, we have to end with the same fucking song. And we're doing it again, because that's what we're annoying. Thank you very much. Thanks for coming out to the show. No, that's what rock stars do. No.
Go outside. Go outside. We're done.
Thanks a lot for everyone that came down. Remember, we do shows every Saturday. There's other events all week long. Come down and support ABC.
If you want to write to us, Avail is P.O. Box 4785, Richmond, Virginia, 23220, USA.
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 Yeah.